Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Just a couple of days ago, I actually reviewed and tested the GTR 2E. Well, today I decided to bring you a review and test of the GTS 2E. So these two watches, these two smartwatches, are actually sitting right bang in the middle of the Amazfit smartwatch range. And as we have picked up earlier, there's something not quite right in regards to heart rate readings. So what I've done with the GTR 2E, I've actually tested its heart rate, active heart rate, resting heart rate, as well as GPS. And we have seen vast improvements that were probably updated via OTA. Now, with the GTS 2E, I've also done the same tests. So we have a test of heart rate readings during my walk across some forest land, and then I've done a heart rate test during a circuit workout. Also, I've tested the GPS, and in some areas we've seen improvements, while in some nothing much has changed. Anyways, let's get into the details and talk about the test and review, where I will show you the plots, the charts, and you can make up your own conclusions.
If you are new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
So as I've just mentioned, we're going to be testing the GTS 2E according to two exercises. So in one of them, I was actually walking through a bit of parkland and forest land for just under 40 minutes. Now during that test, I've also measured the GPS. So let's kick off with that. So we can see that I've actually traveled or walked, well, quite a brisk walk for about 40 minutes, and I've traveled a distance as measured by iPhone 12 at 3.22 kilometers. While for the same trip, the GTS 2E actually measured a distance of 3.02 kilometers. What does that mean? That means that we can see an understatement of 6%, or about 200 meters short of what the iPhone GPS receiver is showing us. Is that a major difference? Not sure, but we can definitely say that the GTR 2E GPS is performing much better. But anyways, so that's the GPS. If we actually look at the heart rate, let's take a look at the heart rate now. So for the benchmark, we actually use the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. As we all know, that is one of the benchmarks that's used across the industry, be it for scientific studies, be it for tests, reviews, and that's what professional athletes use because of its high accuracy and precision. Anyways, so that was the benchmark, and of course, the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the GTS 2E is what we've actually been testing. So, what we see during the walk for the 38 minutes, we can see that the Polar H10 average heart rate reading is 111 beats per minute, while the max is 120. Now, the GTS 2E is showing us also 111 beats per minute as the average, while the max is 132. So, there's no variance on the average, which is excellent, but the max is off by 12 beats per minute or 10%. Now, if we actually look at the plot, we can see that for the first 80%, there was almost no variance. So basically, the heart rate as read by the heart rate sensor on the back of the GTS 2E was very close to the Polar H10 strap. We came to issues right at the end of it. For some reason, the GTS 2E picked up a spike, and it picked it up and it showed us 132 max. But obviously, because it was just one spike, it did not affect the average. So we can see definitely some improvement, because in the previous tests that we did with the GTS 2E, the heart rate was just all over the show. Now we can see that during stable exercise, we can see that the heart rate is close to what the Polar H10 chest strap was showing us. Now, I wasn't exactly comfortable with just those results. So I thought I'm going to get into some circuit training, and well, for part of that circuit training, I would have the Polar ECG chest strap on me, as well as the watch. So the GTS 2E, which we've got right here. And that's what I did. And this is where everything went pear-shaped. Let me show you the results. So we've got the plot of the Polar H10 ECG chest strap, and over it, we've got the chart from the optical heart rate sensor on the GTS 2E. Let's take a look at it. As I've just mentioned, this is where things went hairy. So the Polar H10 chest strap picked up the average heart rate at 141 beats per minute with the max of 163. Now the GTS 2E picks up 112 as the average, 142 as the max. And that's a problem, because the variance is a shortage or understatement of 29 beats per minute for the average, and a shortage or an understatement of 21 beats per minute for the max. Now that's 20.6% and 12.9%. That is quite significant. As I was doing the measurement, I had the GTS 2E on my left wrist. Now I was getting quite worried about these results. I thought, no, it has to be something wrong. So I picked up the old Amazfit GTS. Do you remember this bad boy? If you actually look at them, they do look kind of similar, don't they? So this is the GTS, the original one, the one that spiked up a lot of interest across the globe for the Amazfit brand. Well, I've actually put this on 3 minutes into the exercise, and just let me show you a chart. You have to take a look. Now, I was impressed with how the GTS handled it. Just take a look at those results. 148 beats per minute as the average, with the max at 166 beats per minute. So even though it was only running for 12 minutes out of the 50, the GTS 2E, it still managed to accurately, with precision, follow the H10 ECG chest strap. Anyways, I hope that you've enjoyed this review and test. If you have, then please drop us a like. If you want to see more of the same, if you want to keep up to date with the latest news, with the latest trends in smartwatches, fitness trackers, smart bands, then you know what to do. Please hit the red subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.